You know, archaeology really is everywhere under our feet, but to have such well-preserved Fremont archaeology only 15 minutes from campus is quite unique. We've been able to uncover what here is a pretty traditional Fremont pit house. One of the things that sets BYU's anthropology department apart is the amount of technology that we're trying to incorporate into our field methods. So in collaboration with several other departments at the university, we have been able to develop new technology, much of which was developed and designed by other students. So some of the new technology that we're using here includes a wireless network system that pairs with tablet devices.
We have this ArcNet. Has its own solar panels to power it. We have a few stationed along the site, and they make our own little intranet.
We have computer science students actually building an app for tablets, which allow us to transmit and save our data on a server that we have.
Anything that we find, it all gets assigned a very specific number so that we can take notes on that. So we're taking notes on everything throughout the day, down to the very specifics. And it's accessible to, you know, our directors over in the trailer, back on campus, it's all there.
We are also using drone technology to not only record the archaeology that we're uncovering, but also to try to discover pieces of the archaeology that may still be covered underground. Most of our excavations and operations are out in remote locations where there is no electricity or access to electricity. Over the last 7 weeks, not once have we had to tap into any electricity. We've had enough solar energy to charge our equipment, to keep our server running, and keep our intranet here working as well. The other aspect of archaeological research in terms of academia and our field schools is to make discoveries, right? That's why we're out here. Only minutes ago, one of our students found a Fremont figurine. They would make these little clay figures and shape them in the form of people. These artifacts haven't been touched or seen for over 1,000 years, and you're the first one that gets to touch it and pull it out of the ground. And then you get to help tell the story of who these people were and how they lived their lives. So I think that's what keeps us going. What's going to be in that next trowel scrape? What's going to be in that next shovelful? So we feel that all of these things together are giving students an edge, and that's something that's very unique to BYU and our program in terms of trying to really get at that frontier of technological advancement and methods in archaeology.